Commencement. Welcome. I'm Dr. Mike Mathias, Interim Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs. Before we proceed with today's ceremony, there are several announcements to make. First announcement is required by the Norman Fire Prevention Code. The exit doors have been inspected and are unlocked. For your own safety, look for the nearest exit. In case of emergency, please walk. Do not run to that exit. We now remind you to please silence your electronic devices. We also ask that guests not leave their seats to take pictures during the ceremony. Doing so often blocks the view of others and is against regulations set by the state fire marshal. There will be a professional photographer taking pictures of the graduates as they cross the platform to receive their diplomas. Please also refrain from blocking the rear entrances to this arena, which also is prohibited by the state fire marshal. The audience is also reminded that face masks are required to be worn throughout the ceremony and while inside the building. Today is a very special day for everyone here. We understand that many of the friends and family of today's graduates will want to acknowledge their accomplishments with enthusiasm. We welcome you to do so. However, we also ask that you respect the dignity of this ceremony and be considerate of everyone by keeping your applause brief so that the name of each graduate will be clearly heard. Please refrain from extremely loud or extensive displays of celebration out of respect for the graduates who follow yours. At the end of the ceremony, we will ask the guests not leave their seats until after the recessional, when all students have left the arena. We thank you in advance for your understanding and cooperation. And now let us begin. The nearly 1,000-year-old tradition of commencement begins with the entry of the Grand Marshal, carrying the university news. This year, we are led by one of our most senior and respected faculty members, Dr. James Hikou, Professor of Geography. Frostburg State University faculty and professional staff are led by the faculty marshals, Dr. Jacqueline Durs, Associate Professor of Kinesiology and Recreation, and Dr. Matthew Crawford, Associate Professor of Chemistry. As the faculty and staff enter, you will notice the dignity and pageantry of the traditional commencement, as symbolized by the academic regalia worn by the participants. The mortar boards and robes that serve as symbols of intellectual pursuit may be traced back to the medieval universities of Europe. Information regarding the regalia can be found in your program. Thank you. president's stage party includes the officers of the university and other participants in today's ceremony. The institution's first commencement was held at the Frostburg Football House on June 10, 1904. At that ceremony, Governor Edwin Warfield presented flowers to eight young women graduating from State Normal School number 2. Today we celebrate the 150th commencement at Frostburg State University. There are 470 candidates, all of which will receive degrees today. Candidates for degrees will be led by the faculty marshals and will be introduced today by Dr. Michael Monahan, Professor of Management, Dr. Debbie Welch, Professor of Educational Professions, and Dr. Amy Brandon Barnienko, Professor of English. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and welcome the Frostburg State University graduating class of 2021. Thank you. It's not my pleasure to turn these proceedings over to Dr. James McHugh, University of Illinois Center. The University of Illinois has declared the Canada 59 Commencement exercise open. The audience will please remain standing and join in singing the national anthem led by the two members. Thank you.
I'm so glad you can all be here today to witness this important moment in the students' lives. On behalf of the Frostburg State University faculty and staff, I welcome you to the 2021 Leader Commencement Ceremony, the 159th Commencement Ceremony, and the first in 2 years. We have taken several steps for your safety and health today. The most important action you can do today to help us is to wear your mask at all times. We are requiring everyone to wear their mask even when they cheer for their students crossing the stage. Please help us, and more importantly, to the safety of everyone sitting near you, continue to wear your mask. And I thank you for complying with that request. We are celebrating today not just those of us sitting here today, but with many more loved ones all around the world who are witnessing our ceremony streamed on the internet. Our tradition is to send a welcome to all those viewers online. At the count of three, say hello from Frostburg. 1, 2, 3. Hello from Frostburg! I would also like to take a moment to recognize military veterans among our graduates and our audience today. As the number of veteran and military students continues to grow, we have been able to see the positive influence we all have in our university community. Will all the veterans and active duty military here today please stand so that we can express our gratitude to you for your service? Graduates to invite the faculty or staff member to this ceremony who made a difference in their time here. I'm pleased that nearly 20 individuals were invited by students, some more than once, and many of whom are seated on this stage or in the audience. I ask that all faculty and staff in attendance please stand to be recognized. We're celebrating the achievement of an important goal today, that of receiving, no, earning a college degree. For each graduate, because challenge is unique to you because of the pandemic we have all experienced over the past 20 plus months. I believe your degree will open up doors for each of you to become engaged and successful citizens and leaders. Know that you are following in the footsteps of many other successful Frostburg State University graduates. And those other graduates, the alumni of Frostburg State University, are there to support you. We are very pleased to have been part of this journey, and know that as part of the Frostburg State University family, you can call on us if you tackle those new challenges ahead. Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2021.
My name is Dr. Sabir Singh, and I'm the Dean of the College of Business. I'll be honored to present to you Mr. Trent Keller as a commencement speaker from the College of Business. His biography and his performance's accomplishments can be found in the program, and after the faculty and students of the College of Business, I am proud to present to you our commencement speaker, Mr. Tom Kimmel.
Hi, guys. Hello, fellow graduates and families. Congratulations on this much anticipated accomplishment. First off, I'd like to thank some people who helped me get to this point. Thank you to my parents, who are the most selfless people I know. They also mentioned the very announcement to play and their family gets a forgiven. Thank you to my siblings who always keep me humble and inspire me to keep working hard every day. Thank you to Dr. McCarty who made my transition from a community college to Frostburg State very seamless. And lastly, thank you to all my other professors that I've had throughout my time here at Frostburg and during my time at Hendrickstown Community College. I want to share a piece of advice that has really had a positive impact on my life recently. Dr. Jordan D. Peterson is a clinical psychologist who wrote a book titled 12 Rules for Life and Inability to Chaos. Rule number 4 states, compare yourself to who you were yesterday, not to who someone else is today. It's so easy to fall into the trap of using others as a measuring stick for how we define success for ourselves, especially in today's age of social media. But that's a terrible way to define success for yourself because nobody else has been in your exact situation and has had your exact life experiences. It's far better to compare yourself to who you were yesterday, who you were 6 months ago, or even who you were 4 years ago when you were just starting college. There's so much fulfillment to be found in personal growth. Dr. Peterson recommends to you to basically ask yourself, what could I do that I would do to make life a little better? I'll repeat that question again. What could I do that I would do to make life a little better? The answers to this question will vary for every individual. For some, this could be drinking more water each day, starting an exercise routine you've been thinking about, getting outside your comfort zone and attending that social event you got invited to, and so on. We all know the first step that we need to take. It's just a matter of overcoming the initial resistance we feel, and that ultimately will just spread. From my experience, if you ask yourself this question honestly, and then take action on your answers, then you'll feel much better about yourself and realize you're the one in control of your own life. I hope these strenuous lessons are going to help some of you as we go into this next phase of our lives. My name is Trent Kelly. Thank you for listening, and good luck, everyone.
Good morning. My name is Dr. Boyce C. Williams, and I'm the Dean of the College of Education. I'm proud to introduce to you our speaker today, Ms. Caitlin Elwell. Her biography and list of some of her accomplishments can be found in your program. On behalf of the faculty and students of the College of Education, I am pleased to present to you our commencement speaker, Ms. Caitlin Elwell. Good morning, Frostburg State University staff, students, alumni, friends, and family members. To begin my remarks, I would like to make note of how proud everyone in this room should be themselves right now. These past few semesters have certainly been difficult, especially with the situations brought on by the outside world. Despite the many hardships, difficulties, and uncertainties, each of us in this room is strong enough to see it through. We each have had our own unique journey, not only academically, but as individuals to get where we are today. During my last 2 semesters in college, I have been interning as a student teacher at an elementary and middle school setting. Being in those classrooms and getting to better know the climate and culture of my students was truly a valuable experience. Not only did I learn how to teach curriculum and be present in daily activities, but I've also become aware of some health realities. Not everyone has a stable home, a piece of security, a loving family, or sometimes a home to come back to at all. Such life experiences are not only here in today's world, but also present in this very community. I lost my fortune. I'm eternally grateful for all the help and amazing family and loving group of friends at home. Being in a classroom with a diverse group of students has truly opened my eyes to just some of the different realities people face each day. The specific and significant moment that I remember from my time as a student teacher was when the class had a bill from Native American Center for Natural Resources. It could be sticks, leaves, tree bark, and the construction of all sorts of glue down the cardboard. A few days after the students began the assignment, one of the students walked up to me, the biggest smile on his face, and says, "So when do you get to get our focus?" He hadn't realized that there was an assignment to complete at home and not during the school day. Once I told him he had to complete it at home, his excited grin had vanished. He walked over to his seat and continued to finish it. When I asked him what was wrong, his response was, "It's stupid and I don't want to do it anymore." My heart sank. I knew that this student didn't have the best home life to come back to. My intuition told me to buy some yarn, cardboard, and anything else I could get my hands on so that this student could participate in the project that he was once so excited about. I put a number of materials in a bag and gave it to the student at dismissal the day before the project was due. The very next morning, this student had previously shut down and all of a sudden had to do it at home. I ended up being the very first student to arrive in class and proudly say, "Look at what I did." He immediately started to discover the how he built it, what he built, and all the other excitement. The moral of this story is that sometimes we just need someone to believe in us and to look out for one another. Each of us, just like the students, have had very different experiences that shape us into who we are. It is important for each of us to recognize this and understand that not everyone in this room has had the same journey to get to this stage here today. Every student here today has some type of battle to overcome, and I want to express how proud I am of each and every one of us. Because sometimes we just need one person to believe us. We need to learn to support each other and try to be a greater version of ourselves than we were yesterday. While most of us do not remember the name of strangers who showed us kindness or opportunity, we will always remember the way changes here. As my internship school would say, it is our duty to be responsible, respectful, and an expert learner. I have hopes that this model sticks with us throughout our life because learning never stops. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2021.
Good morning. I am Dr. Kim Hicks and I'm the Dean of the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Today, I have the privilege of introducing Miss Shelly Jo Cabot, who graduates today with a bachelor's in health science with a minor in chemistry. Her biography and list of some of her accomplishments can be found in your program. On behalf of the faculty and the students of the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, I am pleased to present to you our commencement speaker, Ms. Shelly Jo Cabot.
FSU became my second home. I found my happy place to be on a small table on a third floor company. I never forget the Christmas cards that were put in the bag. father, I cannot describe the college experience like the opening of a world standard. I'm choosing to face the most seriously. As I look back over my 3.5 years, I can recall many times where I get 3, maybe 4 hours of sleep because I feel very interested. And I would give my own state in front of the computer from the time I woke up until I went to bed, which is fine. So ask yourself, how did I get through this whole thing? And the answer is that I did. My mom would sit and go over Frostburg with me for hours, with words like soldiers to death and help bring me to running. So honestly, this is probably the real one. And my dad was always there to tell me that he was proud of me and knew that the good news would just take all this. And then there's my sister, who liked to roll her eyes at me every time I wanted to listen to the family's rich. And then she was proud of me and she was happy to find her sister. And my poor boyfriend, who was known me for years to make sure she was going to be using. I would be afraid about it because he's telling me my study time, but I would never expect it to be a kid. And then finally, I had my books. The little ones have always been that I built me, but I never wanted them to die very unpleasant because it was the first time I was a sentence. My college experience for me, although it was extremely rewarding, also came along very anxiety and depressing. And probably my BA degree, I didn't have the same experience. We made fun of the family children, but then we would always go out and sing at the top of our lungs while getting drunk and eating pizza. They were like my own great breakfasts. So, we took friendship for ups and downs, and that was our life. We were always there for each other. We just stayed at the head of the bottom of the heart. So my advice for all of you today is to go out and find a support group if you haven't already. Find your people and hold on to them. This is just the beginning of the journey for most of us, and I can promise you that the experience is so much better when you have people that you like to share with. I wish all of you the best of luck on the journey, and congratulations.
Let's have another round of applause for our three commencement speakers. Thank you. Before we proceed with the granting of degrees, I want to give our students the opportunity to thank all those family and friends who helped get you where you are today. Students, please stand, face your loved ones, and give them a round of applause. And how many less important sentiments. We will now proceed with the granting of degrees.
Candidates for the doctoral degree in education, the Master of Arts in Teaching, the Master's degree in Education, and the Master of Science in Recreation and Parks Management. Please rise and continue to stand. For the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science from the College of Education, please rise and continue to stand.
Candidates for the master's degree in the College of Business, please rise and continue to stand. Candidates for the degrees, the Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science from the College of Business, please rise and continue to stand. For the master's degree in the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, please rise and continue to stand. Candidates
more of a bachelor's degree from the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, including. Including students in the Collaborative Engineering Program with the University of Maryland College Park. Please rise and continue to study.
President Navarro, I have the honor to present to you and the recommendation of the faculty of Frostburg State University, the degree candidates for December 2021.
I just have to say, I hope everybody's standing. I wasn't quite sure about the degrees, but everybody should be standing now.
I have the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the University System of Maryland and the Chancellor of the University System of Maryland, Dr. Jay Pullman, and upon the recommendations of the faculty and the deans of the Colleges of Business, Education, or Liberal Arts and Sciences, I confer upon you upon certification of the completion of your studies, your degree, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereof. Congratulations. Please be seated. At this time, the university recognizes those category of degree candidates who have distinguished themselves by their academic excellence. Undergraduate students who have demonstrated outstanding academic performance will graduate with one of the following distinctions: cum laude, magna cum laude, or summa cum laude. The distinction of graduating cum laude is awarded to those students whose cumulative grade point average on a 4.0 scale is between 3.40 and 3.64. Distinction of graduating magna cum laude is awarded to those students who have a cumulative grade point average between 3.65 and 3.89. The distinction of graduating summa cum laude is awarded to those students whose cumulative grade point average is 3.9 or above. Undergraduate students who have achieved these academic honors are wearing gold tassels as part of their academic regalia. Those undergraduate students graduating with honors will please rise at this time and be recognized. Congratulations on your high honor.
We will now proceed with the presentation of performance. I remind you that we welcome the audience to acknowledge the graduates' accomplishments with enthusiasm. However, we also ask that you respect the dignity of ceremony to consider with anyone, by keeping the applause brief so that the need of each graduate will be thrown away. And I ask that graduates cross the stage and take 5 minutes. Please continue to wear your face mask as you cross the stage, although you may remove it momentarily for the formal photo taken at the bottom of the ring. Thank you.
We will now present the diplomas for the doctoral degree. Historically, a doctoral degree candidate wears a hood. This academic hood wears FSU's colors and the color of the student's individual field of study. It is this hood that symbolizes the high achievement of the doctoral student who has completed a rigorous course of study with honor and distinction. Doctoral degree candidates, please rise and come forward to receive your diploma from Dr. Navarro. Leading candidates is Dr. Jody Rouse, Professor of Educational Professions and Marshal for the College of Education, who will announce their names and dissertation titles. Doctoral degree candidates, as you named as well, please approach the stage.
Doctor of Education, Jennifer Webster.
We now present students get a master's degree. Historically, a master's degree candidate also wears a third band that has used colors and the color of the individual student's field of study, which symbolizes the high achievement of the master's student who is completing a rigorous course of study without any distinction. Master's degree candidates, these rise and come forward to receive your diplomas from Dr. Malazzo. Even the candidates are Dr. Michael Huntington, Marshall for the College of Business, Marshall Welsh for the College of Education, and Dr. Amy Brandon-Arminenzo, Marshall for the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Master's degree candidates, as you've already read, please approach the stage.
Of Education, Rebecca Mary Arbinger. Carrie Ballard. Chelsea Dawn Orr. Master of Science in Recreation Parks and Sports Management, Christian S. Fahey. Nathaniel Fargo. Thank you.
How much for the bachelor's degree? Candidates, if you need this role, please approach the stage to receive the diploma from President Obama.
the key elements.
Thank you. Thank you.
place to explain the world.
Thank you.
to bring that to our leaders, not to walk them.
Thank you. I'm not to be real, sir. I'm not to be real, sir. I'm not to be real, sir.
graduates.
Thank you. Thank you.